In persons with type 2 diabetes, metformin is the primary glucose-lowering medication recommended, but a second medication is often needed. A new trial compares the efficacy of four commonly used medications in achieving and maintaining glycated hemoglobin levels when added to metformin. In this multicenter parallel group randomized clinical trial, 5,047 participants with metformin-treated type 2 diabetes diagnosed within the previous 10 years, whose level of glycated hemoglobin was between 6.8% and 8.5% at trial baseline, were assigned to receive insulin glargine U100, the sulfonylurea glimepiride, the GLP-1 receptor agonist liraglutide, or the DPP-4 inhibitor sitagliptin, in addition to receiving approximately 2,000 milligrams of metformin daily. During an average follow-up of 5 years, the primary outcome, metabolic failure, defined as a glycated hemoglobin level of 7.0 or higher, differed significantly among the four groups. The rate with glargine was 26.5 per 100 participant years, similar to the rate of 26.1 with liraglutide, both of which were lower than the rates of 30.4 with glimepiride and 38.1 with sitagliptin. Severe hypoglycemia occurred infrequently overall, but was seen more often with glimepiride. The authors conclude that in persons with metformin-treated type 2 diabetes, all four additional glucose-lowering medications improved the glycated hemoglobin level. But glargine and liraglutide were significantly, although modestly, more effective than sitagliptin or glimepiride. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.